You're watching NCAA Gymnastics on Big 12 Now on ESPN+. Today, West Virginia celebrates 50 years of gymnastics by facing rival Pitt and a pair of teams that have already clinched regular season conference titles, Towson and Western Michigan. And welcome to the WVU Coliseum, Michael Minnick alongside Kaylin Millick. Kaylin, this is a big day for all four of these teams.
It's a really important competition today, Michael. Each of these teams are chasing a spot for that NCAA regional championship. Towson and Western are just on the cusp of that 36th spot, where Pitt and West Virginia are looking to improve their NQS today. It's going to be a good one.
A lot of great gymnasts for these teams. Let's talk about four of them. First for Towson, Isabella Minervini.
Isabella Minervini, she has been such an incredible athlete for this team, posting 9.975s on bars this season. I'm excited to watch her here in the Coliseum today.
Peyton Murphy's come back with a neck injury to be the best all-rounder in the MAC.
Unbelievable. She is two-time MAC Gymnast of the Year. She's a 2023 co-MAC champion. She's resilient. She's a coach's dream. And also, again, excited to see her here today as well.
And then for Pitt, Jordan Ewing's beating some Olympians on the bars this year.
Jordan has been a stellar competitor for this Pitt gymnastics team. She loves to compete. She wants to be at her best for the team. She leads by example, and she's going to lead them on the way today.
Abby Pearson's going to rock for West Virginia. Fifth year has really been an all-rounder just about every meet for them.
Abby's been stellar. She had a little bit of mishaps on Friday at Penn State. She's eager to redeem herself today.
Let's take a look at the coaches. It's the first backyard brawl for a new coach at Pitt, Casey Joe McPherson, coming over from a long time as an assistant in the SEC at Missouri. Western Michigan has already clinched the MAC championship. Penny Durrigan's really built this program over the years. You see their record, a sterling 12-2 on the campaign. And the same story really for Towson. Jay Ramirez has his program getting season highs and breaking their own records. Jason Butts, meanwhile, for West Virginia, has really had to deal with a younger lineup, Kaylin.
Yeah, unfortunately for West Virginia this year, having to deal with some injuries, you never know what to expect, but he's really had to rely on their freshman class this year. It's taken them a little bit to find their way in that regard, but they've been putting up some bigger numbers this past couple weeks, so we'll see what they have to do today.
West Virginia starts on vault, Towson on bars, Western Michigan on the beam, and Pitt on the floor. Brooke Alban leads things off for West Virginia, and then for Towson on bars, we will see Lauren Keener. Always a lot of pressure to be the very first routine of the day, especially at home, Kaylin.
We talk about this a lot, just how important that leadoff spot is on every event, but just to start off the whole entire meet, that's just going to set the tone for each of these athletes. A nice Uchenko full for West Virginia on vault over there. She did take a big hop. Again, we keep reiterating the rule this year of you have to be able to control that landing. That's something that each of these coaches talk about. Today, the gymnastics has to be there. You have to be consistent, but you also have to be dynamic, and the execution's got to be there as well.
Brooke Alban's been incredibly consistent. Every score this year involved between 9.675 and 9.75. She's had five 9.75s this year.
It's exciting for Brooke. She's a junior on the team this year, so she understands what it takes. So to rely on somebody that has experience to take that leadoff spot, it just sets the tone for the whole meet for West Virginia.
This Towson group has been excellent on bars, 28th in the nation entering action today. And Lauren Keener has a season best of a 9.85.
She's got a good routine going here. Unfortunately, at the beginning, she had missed that blind chain, so she had to restart the team. She had to restart the routine. So. Unfortunately, going to count a fall here for her, but again, she was able to come back strong and get the routine the second time.
Moving over to beam, Western Michigan's leadoff spot. It will be Danny Petruzic.
Western Michigan has talked about how they lost some confidence along the way on this event, really trying to build a lineup that's going to be confident and make sure they get the job done. At the point where they got to start figuring that out, especially going into postseason. The MAC championship isn't easy, so they definitely have to figure out the kinks to get to that meet and just be the best they can be at that meet.
Sierra Ward starting on four for Pitt.
Sierra Ward is a fifth year for this Pitt gymnastics team. So we talk a lot about these fifth years and just the experience they had through COVID and just the unique perspective they get to bring just to be, you know, you never know what's going to happen. So you have to enjoy every opportunity.
Mentioned Brooke Alban's consistency, another 9.75 to lead off for West Virginia.
Good start for West Virginia. Again, I want to start to see these scores in the 9.8 ranges, but hopefully they can just build from there.
Let's Sierra Ward on floor, where she's also been very consistent and very good. She's the best of a 9.85. She's been 9.775 or better in the last three meets for the Panthers.
I was excited to talk to Jason about Sierra this week. She's definitely come into her own. She has college experience, but she doesn't necessarily have D1 experience. So Jason said we've had to really try to control her energy a little bit and focus on the details, realize that consistency is going to build confidence, and you can do that simply. You don't have to, change your mindset. You just have to focus on the quality of your gymnastics, and she's really been doing that the last couple weeks.
Off goes Sierra Monzon, vault for West Virginia.
A nice Uchenga full. You saw it from the back end. A little bit of split legs. You can see her college experience there. Jason always talks about the energy he wants to see the team bring. He felt like they brought a lot of energy at Oklahoma this past weekend, put up a great score on the road. He wants to see that continue to go throughout this meet and throughout the season.
Kaylin, you alluded to it. It's a double meet weekend for two of these teams. How tough is that to compete on the road 2 out of 3 days?
It's not easy, Michael, but unfortunately it's become a part of the sport. So it's kind of just a mindset you have to get used to. At this point in the season, you just have to go and, Towson has a longer week to recover next weekend, so they really wanted to just focus on, hitting the ground running, especially two meets on the road this weekend, and then going home and finishing up the season strong.
This is Lauren Green on bars for Towson, Chi-Chi Singh on the beam for Western Michigan.
Very beautiful combination there. It's going to be really important for Towson to, they have a little bit of added pressure with the fall in the first routine there, but other than the step on the end, that honestly was a beautiful routine.
Yeah, 9.125 to lead off for Towson. Petruzic puts a 9.6 up on beam. Singh getting ready to dismount for the Broncos on the beam. And a deep breath for Kennedy Duke, another one of these pit gymnasts to watch before she takes the floor.
Good routine going for Western Michigan here. Nice gainer pike off the ends. She does get the stick, however, her chest is a little bit down. Like I said, each of these teams need to hit routines today. 24 for 24 is always the goal, but the execution at this point in the season, especially when all of these teams are chasing spots in the postseason here, Michael, is really, really going to be important, and that's what's going to set these teams apart.
.975, the score being shown on the judge on the near side, and a 9.7 on this side. So a 9.725 on bars for Green and Towson in their second position.
Moving things along here, we have Jaden, who is a freshman for this West Virginia team. She's just recently added vault. Again, I talked about how Jason's had to rely on these freshmen a little bit more to fill some lineup spots. But the good thing about it is they're getting experience, they're getting exposure. It's going to set them up for a good sophomore season. And Jaden's really been getting the job done.
Kennedy Duke coming off a 9.825 against NC State last week. She's been in and out of the former lineup due to injuries, but came back last week and put up a good score.
A nice Uchenka full for West Virginia on the left side there. Yes, Kennedy is one of those athletes that Casey Joe said has really been improving her confidence throughout her sophomore year at Pitt. She has a real desire to improve for the team, and so she's just coming into her routine a little bit better this year and having fun with it.
Brooke Albin scores up here to a 9.65. Sierra Munns also with a 9.65 on vault for West Virginia. 9.675 leading off on four for Pitt. Western Michigan's got a 9.6 for Petruzic and a 9.4 for Gigi Singh. So really, none of these teams are probably too happy with how this has started, Kaylin.
It's a really important competition. When we talked to Jason about whether postseason is an opportunity or not, there's always a Cinderella story. You never know on the day of competition what each athlete's going to bring. Everyone has to be on their A game, but that's not always possible. So making sure that you're in your zone and, focusing on your team and doing good quality gymnastics for each athlete on your particular team. You can't focus on what anyone else is doing. So this is why this competition today is really important. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Good save on being there for Hannah Milton of Western Michigan to keep her routine alive.
You can tell they're just a little bit shaky up there. I know this isn't an event that they, like I mentioned earlier, aren't as confident on. It's hard to start on this event. It's a very mental event. So you got to make sure that you're mentally able to go through every rotation with that.
Yeah, this has been their weakest event. They're tied for 44th in the nation with their NQS. Good dismount there.
They are staying on the equipment, but something that Penny had mentioned was when we asked her what her goals were for this competition, where we want to leave the connections, you know, we want to make sure the connections are there. We want to make sure that the judges don't have anything to discuss. So making sure that don't leave any conversation up for grabs is what they really wanted to focus on.
Grad student up one Barnes, Camille Vitoff dismounting.
Huge full in dismount. Chest is up, tiny, tiny hop, but good, good finish for that Barra team.
Third up on floor for Pitts will be Kaylee Larson.
We have Kiana Lewis here going on vault with a huge, huge Yuchenko full. That vault has been consistently getting better every single meet. She scored a 9.9. I think it was at OU a couple weeks ago.
2 days ago, yes.
at Penn State 2 days ago. She's worked really, really hard. Her confidence wasn't quite there at the beginning of the year, but gosh, look at the senior just doing her job and doing it well.
When you have come off a 9.9 like that and she's eating after that routine, I'm sure you want to get right back after her like she did. You take a day off and you keep the momentum going.
You know, and that's part of gymnastics. You just get that kind of, you know, confidence as you go through the season. It becomes easy. It's actually like meet day is the easy part, you know. You get through the weeks, you just try to recover your body. But she's been doing an incredible, incredible job on that event.
Sarah Moravansky mounting the beam for Western Michigan. She's the best of a 9.85 that came back in their meet against Ball State 2 weeks ago.
And Sarah is one of those athletes that Western Michigan really relies on. She's a senior. She's somebody that Coach Penny said that, you know, all the girls really look up to by her work ethic and just her demeanor, and she's an important role on this team.
Jaden McDonald's vault spring a 9.7 for Western Michigan. That's their best through three gymnasts so far. Towson's team score, 28.450 through three routines. Pitts put up a pair of solid scores on floor.
It feels like after that kind of third, fourth routine here, Michael, that each of these teams are kind of getting in their groove a little bit more. So we'll see how they continue to build throughout the meet.
And a 9.875 for Kiana Lewis on vault. Dismount on beam by Moravansky. So four gymnasts have competed now for Western Michigan on the beam. Waiting her turn to go on bars for Towson is Clara Hong. And as we mentioned, this is Larson on floor for Pitts. Abby Pearson giving final instructions from Jason Butts before her vault for West Virginia.
I really want to see Abby just kind of have fun today. Like I said, she had some mistakes at Penn State this Friday, some uncharacteristic mistakes for her. The important thing for her today is just going to be to come out and redeem herself and just enjoy it today. I would say that was a pretty good
start. That's a good start, right.
Huge Yuchenko full, tiny, tiny bit of a hop in the end, but that's the way you want to come out after ending on the bars routine that she messed up on Friday.
Clara Hong up on bars for Towson.
Beautiful shoot over handstand there. Clara is somebody that Towson really relies on as well. She was kind of battling some injuries. She's working her way back into bars, beam, and floor, but
9.75 for her 2 days ago.
Really difficult dismount. That front double front, you don't see the landing as well. It's a blind landing, so it takes a little bit of a step backwards, but again, that's a difficult routine.
Samantha Gruber on beam for Western Michigan. Gruber coming up a 9.85 at Illinois State last time out for this Western Michigan team, which has already clinched the MAC regular season at 4-0. Towson doing the same in the Eagle.
Nice back handspring layout for her series on beam. Beautiful switch half. Really difficult jump series there. A lot of bonus in that. Switch half to straddle quarter. I mentioned how important execution is for all these teams today, especially on beam. You want to be able to see that 180 split, if not above it. Don't want to give anything the judges can take away. And that's the perfect example. Round off 1.5 dismounts, stuck the landing. I would take absolutely nothing on that dismount there, Michael. Good, good progression here for Western Michigan on the beam.
want, again, to do it after some pressure. You've got a 9-4 up there that you don't want to count with one routine to go now.
And I think to be able to come after a mistake or not the score you want, you know, you have to be on your game, and I think they're really stepping up to the challenge over there, and Towson as well on bars.
Up goes Grace Valancourt for Towson. She's probably her best event, although she's excellent on four as well.
Beautiful combination on bars. You also just saw Emma Weary with the only 10-0 vault that West Virginia has on that event. Really, really huge vault. Did take the step, but talk about a beautiful routine for Towson. After making a mistake, we talked about how important that is to just come back and get your job done individually to overall improve your team score. Grace just did a really, really nice job.
Pearson with a 9.85 vault in front of Emma Weary. Solid on beam as well from Gruber, a 9.825 to set up their star, really in this event and every event. Peyton Murphy will go sixth. We mentioned it earlier, Kaylin. I can't imagine coming back from a broken neck in this sport and still having confidence.
Unbelievable. You know, injury, unfortunately, is a part of sport, especially when you do it for so long in such a high level. Gymnastics isn't the easiest sport. You have to have air awareness, but something that Penny said she was most proud of was that she was determined. A lot of girls probably wouldn't have ever wanted to do bars again, but she was like, no, I'm going to come back. I know I can do this. And she just had this fire in her. Like I mentioned earlier, she's a coach's dream and just kind of what the standard for Western Michigan gymnastics is when they look for recruits.
West Virginia with a 48.9 on their vault rotation. This is Emily Todd competing for Pitt on four.
Really hard jump series there. She released her head in that ring position. She actually loses sight of the beam, has to be able to keep her hips straight. Arms need to be controlled there. She did that really nicely. And a very beautiful cartwheel gainer pull off the side there.
So Murphy finishing off the rotation for Western Michigan on beam. Already in pretty good shape with a 48.075, pending the scores, will certainly drop their lower score and really raise that up probably a half point.
I would absolutely say that that score is going to really improve their overall beam score.
9.825, the score for Emma Weary. That is her third best of the year on vault, and she has had to fight back from injury this year as well. Missed a couple of meets, missed really the lion's share of three meets, as she was injured at BYU, then had to miss Bowling Green completely, came back on vault in the Mountaineers' home meet against Iowa State in Denver.
Yeah, Jason said she's really been working on just her confidence, you know, not overthinking. Gymnastics for Emma is really easy, but sometimes she gets in her own head a little bit, and Jason said she's starting to enjoy the process a little bit more. I think sometimes when you're out with an injury, you realize, man, I really want to be in there. So not that you want to see that happen, but it does change your mindset a little bit.
Isabella Minervini will close things out on bars for Towson.
Pay attention to this bar routine if you're watching at home. Look at the perfection of her gymnastics. Like I mentioned before, she's posted two consecutive 9.975s on this event. You can see just in her execution how well she is at this event. See if she can get the stick here. And she does it for probably the eighth time in a row this season. She copies and pastes that routine. It is absolutely stunning.
Her lowest score is a 9.875 on bars this year.
You can see why. That was just an absolutely beautiful routine. I keep talking about the execution today. It's there for her. And, you know, I think the Towson team really relies on her, but also the quality of their bar routines were very good, especially after making a mistake. Look how they came back.
Seeing an exhibition on beam right now, dismount from Western Michigan after Murphy's 9.775 to close out the scoring part of the rotation.
I think exhibitions right now are really, really important just because that seventh, eighth spot are really the girls that are pushing that top six to be better. They have to be at their best. So if that seventh, eighth spot is doing a better routine, they're out there being more confident, you're going to get slide in that lineup spot, and that's going to really help you get to the postseason and do really well in the postseason as well.
Pitt still working through the rotation on floor. This will be Jordan Ewing closing things out.
We talked about her a little bit earlier, Michael. She has just been a star.
has really made a leap forward as a junior this year to become a bigger part of the lineup. She has a career best and a season best of a 9.925 in this event.
Opening pass here. Nice, clean double tuck. Lands with her chest up. Having fun with this routine as well. You can see that she's, you know, a veteran on this event, having fun on the floor. Nice 180 splits. I'm having fun with this routine. It's hard not to dance to it.
Has the spotlight to herself with all the other rotations done. And you see West Virginia really has started this meet well, sitting in first place, pending the score from Pitt.
Again, that's been so important, especially this time of the year. You can't really focus on what teams have done around you. Can't really focus on what you've done so far. It's just, how are we going to be the best team we can be today? And that's going to help you get through the season and end the season really strong.
Like you said, it's not an apples-to-apples thing, but to have the lead on your rival early and to have a lead on two conference champions early, that's a confidence boost, I would imagine, going into the second rotation with bars.
Absolutely. You're going to be going into these last few meets feeling really good, but really your job's not done yet. You know, you have to stay focused in the moment. You can't really think about what's happened or what's to come. You got to be really present and just make sure your gymnastics is there in that particular moment.
Still waiting on a couple of scores for Pitt. We will have a couple exhibitions as well before we rotate here, but again, I think bigger picture, Towson's got to be pleased with how they've started, now up to a 48-85 with their final score coming in. Western Michigan fighting for some adversity, put up the 48-4-5 so far, and then again, we'll see what Pitt comes up with from these last couple scores.
I definitely think each of these teams looked like they had a little bit of nerves on that first rotation. This is a big competition. All these teams are really equally matched. They historically have been. It's always been a lot of fun to compete with these teams, especially, you know, Pitt rivalry is always a lot of fun. So, you know, you've got to be on your game.
For Pitt, it's been a lot of duels this year being in the ACC. How different is it to come from almost having a duel every week to going back into a quad?
It is. It's a little bit different. We're working on a new format, which I'm excited about, with the double duel kind of thing for quad meets. But it does throw off the schedule a little bit, but it looks to be moving really smoothly. But yeah, having a dual meet, it moves really smoothly with media and the athletes, the judges. It's just very simple. So, but there's something about a quad meet, though. There's a lot of energy. There's more fans involved. You know, it's a lot of fun.
Correct myself. That was Bedminster that competed last for Pitt. We kind of got out of sequence there. She's got a 9.85. This is Jordan Ewing closing out the rotation. So Pitt looking to drop a 9.675. So far they've been very good and very consistent on four. Three scores of 9.775 or better in the books out of five routines.
Apologies for mixing that up, but to talk about Jalia Bedminster, who's a transfer from Long Island University, she has been a real rock for this Pitt gymnastics team. You know, we talk about experience, and to have that fifth year experience with them who had to go through COVID and just the unknown and being really fluid, and you just have to take whatever's been thrown at you. So I think there's fifth years are a really, really good example for the underclassmen.
Okay, when you've gone through a transition as a gymnast from one conference to another, how difficult is that to be in a new conference and have to adjust to different venues, different opponents?
You know, and we talked about that with Sierra Munns for West Virginia transferring from Texas Women's. You know, it's D2 to D1 transfer, so it's a little bit different. D1, the standards are a little bit higher. Not necessarily that the gymnastics is a lot better, but it's a different experience. West Virginia is a bigger college campus, you know, so I feel like there's a lot that goes into transferring, not only with your gymnastics, but also with just the entire college experience. So you really have to work through that, be confident in it, and communicate with your coaches is really important.
Just tying a bow on bars. Minor Veening with a 9.95. So more of the same from her, more of the amazing from her on that apparatus.
And that's something that each of these teams want. You know, I would assume in practice there's less nerves. You're going to be up doing your best gymnastics, but you want to be able to copy and pace that gymnastics to competition when there's judges involved. You know, that's what's going to set you up for postseason really well.
West Virginia, we've talked about it throughout the season, Kaylin, really having to deal with transition from a great group of seniors last year, injuries as well. I think it took them a while to find their footing and find their rhythm. The last couple meets, they've been much better, especially the last two meets.
They absolutely have, and we talked a little bit about just the energy. I think it's hard when, not only when you lose a lot of key players from the last season and bring in a big freshman class that don't necessarily know how NCAA gymnastics goes, but also to have injuries on top of that, it just ruins the flow a little bit, unfortunately, but you have to be fluid. I mentioned that earlier. But I think, you know, in terms of this West Virginia team, unsure if postseason is there. They still have some time to definitely maximize scores to improve their NQS. You never know what's going to happen. So Jason really just wanted to see them not give up. Be the Cinderella story. Be at 150%. You know, don't just be defeated. Because ultimately, what starting right now is going to set them up for next season. So regardless of what the postseason shows for this West Virginia team, they need to come together at the end of the year, and they have to be able to be cohesive, be strong to finish, and that way it sets them up for a good season next year.
Final score in for Pitt of this rotation. Jordan Ewing leading the way with a 9-8-7-5-4. So Pitt has now nosed ahead of West Virginia at 49 even through the first rotation today.
And Pitt's one of those teams who also has been finding their way. They've had some bright spots with some 196s. They've had some low 193s. But again, new head coach, not really sure what's going to come of the team. But I think together, they're putting it together a little bit better as the season goes on. Figuring out what works, finding their strengths, finding their weaknesses, and just working through those together.
Pitt's got a lot of international gymnasts. Canada, England, even Norway. That's got to make it tougher, too, to kind of figure out, okay, this is a little bit of a different style. This is a little bit different approach. How do I mesh this into making all these gymnasts get the best out of them?
I think it's a lot of fun, and that's something Casey Joe was actually excited about. She said the team really values learning different cultures and expanding their community, not only in Pittsburgh, but throughout the world. So just bringing unique perspectives from each of the athletes. You also kind of have to figure out as a coach what makes them tick. Not only are they new to college, gymnastics, college in general, they're new to the United States, some of them. So it's an adjustment for sure, but I think it's really cool for the Pitt gymnastics team.
So a busy first rotation here at the Coliseum. We will step aside here, come back with the second rotation here on Big 12 Now on ESPN+. Stay with us. So many memories in that video of figures of West Virginia Gymnastics, which we're celebrating today. Here are the first rotation scores, very tight between Pitt and West Virginia for the lead right now, Caitlin.
And we knew this was going to be a tight meet for all of these teams. I mentioned this multiple times, but each of these teams have got to be on their game. They have to be able to execute today, hit the routines, but hit them well.
Let's start by taking a look back at that first rotation with bars. And I thought it was a really good job of Towson bouncing back after some early struggles.
Yeah, especially after the success they've been having. You know, you never want to start an event with a mistake, but for them to come back with quality routines after that, it has to be a confidence booster for them.
Isabella Minervini leading away with a 9.95 on that rotation. And then Kiana Lewis on vault. Has really been on a heater for West Virginia.
Huge vault for Kiana. We've talked about her confidence, you know, throughout the season on that event. She needs to continue to do that to help the West Virginia team grow.
Western Michigan also had to bounce back after some early struggles on beam and did so pretty well.
I still think they're trying to work on their confidence on that event. Still a little bit shaky. I want to see them come out with routines that are a little bit more confident as the season goes on.
And then last but certainly not least, the leaders from Pitt with a 49 on floor.
Really good floor rotation for them. It's important for Pitt to start strong, and they really did that on that event.
Kaylin Millick alongside Michael Minnick. Welcome back here. And How cool is it to see yourself in that video?
It's wild. It's such a surreal thing. You know, it's been over 10 years since I've been on the team, which is just crazy. But I love being involved still. It's so much fun. I have teammates that are behind me coming back to support the team. You know, we just love this program. We love West Virginia, and it's good to see everyone back today.
We're going to talk to some former Mountaineer gymnasts here in a bit, but I would be remiss if I didn't ask you, what has this program meant to you over your life?
It's just been an experience of a lifetime. You know, I actually looked it up today, how many D1 athletes there are in the country. There's like maybe 200,000 of us, and that's a small number for how many people are in the world. So, you know, it's such an honor to be chosen to be able to compete at such a high level, and just to compete for the Flying WV to me is really special, and to everyone that comes through as a Mountaineer gymnast. You know, Linda set up this program just as a family, and we really still value that, and we still keep in touch, and we want to see the program still continue to grow.
Yeah, pretty clear through Linda Burdette Good, and of course all the way through to Jason Butts now, and a couple of Mountaineer gymnasts in the crowd now.
Couple of my Eagle champs right there. Tina was a senior when we won Eagles in 2012. Really, really fun. Alaska was a classmate of mine, so good memories for sure with those two.
Got to wear the championship rings on days like this, right?
What a good day. That was one of the best days of my life. We talked about with Towson winning Eagles last year and just how much that meant to them. You know, I'm lucky to be able to feel that feeling that they're feeling and, you know, just continue to grow. It's really fun.
I loved what Jay Romero said in our interview, that they wanted to make sure they won Eagles before the ACC schools flew the coop and really beat the full conference.
And I think that was a really, really cool perspective that he gave us there. You know, the ACC is going to be a strong conference as well. A lot of the strong Eagle teams left and went to the ACC. So he wanted to be able to show that they're a good team and they can keep up with teams that may be quote-unquote better than them. And gosh, they did it. They nailed it. And they're continuing to grow the program, and it's amazing to watch.
Now they're trying to do the double, win the regular season and the conference meet.
Pretty impressive to be able to go out and be consistent in your training. You know, I asked him kind of what was the theme going through from being Eagle champions last year to, you know, getting this team ready and motivated for this year. He said it's just kind of the standard. We make a vision board. We wanted to go 197. We did that. Our vision was to be a regular season champion. We did that. He was like, we're just going to continue to build goals and just honestly crush them. They've been crushing their own records this year, which is just amazing. And you know, really fun to watch the Towson team and just seeing them grow throughout the years.
I think it's also notable four of their five best scores are on the road this year.
Really important that those road scores are there and, you know, consistent. NQS is three scores have to be on the road to count into that NQS, drop the highest and lowest. So it's just important that they're doing really well on the road as well.
Miranda Smith on Barnes from West Virginia will see Kennedy Duke vault in just a second for Pitts.
Nice routine going for Miranda. She has been such an incredible leadoff on this event and also on balance beam. Nice leadoff vault for Pitt over there. Really clean in the air. See if Miranda can get this stick.
Big cheer from Jason Butts after that.
That's the energy that West Virginia needs. You know, sticks are contagious, routines are contagious. When you have that energy starting from the beginning of the meet, from the beginning of the rotation, you know, vault's over now. We got to focus on bars now. Same with every other team on every other event, you know. It's a new momentum that starts, but you've got to keep the energy throughout.
Miranda Smith's career best is a 9.8. I think we're going to be in the neighborhood of a 9.8 with that routine.
That was a really quality routine for her.
Keener on beam for Towson, Gruber on four for Western Michigan.
Really nice series. Backhand swing out, step out, super clean.
9.8 the score for Kennedy Duke on vault for Pitts. And it will be a 9.875 for Miranda Smith. So a career high by quite a bit, beating the 9.8.
Super exciting start for West Virginia. Nice first pass there for Western Michigan.
Gruber has put up a 9.95 on this event this year. That came back a few weeks ago against Bowling Green at home.
And Amanda has been such a staple for this team. Again, another fifth year. She's been Specialist of the Year as well. MAC Specialist of the Week this year. She just is improved throughout her career. She's super passionate about gymnastics and about Western Michigan. So the fifth year really has been a good example. Unfortunately, got a little tied up on that pass there.
Meanwhile, Lauren Keener bouncing back from a fall on bars to put up a solid beam routine in the leadoff spot for Towson.
Nice leaps. series there. Really important for each of these athletes, after you make a mistake, to not let that affect you. You got to have every other 10 count the rest of the way through the routine.
Gruber finishing up 1-4 for Western Michigan. And off goes Amber Lowe on vault for West Virginia.
A little bit directional there. You can see those lines on the back of the table. Really important that you want to land in between those lines. She was a little bit off on the side of the table, on top of the horse. So definitely going to lose some deductions for the direction there.
Let me correct myself. That was Araya Simons faulting for Pitt. This will be low on bars for West Virginia. Keener led out with a 9.751 beam for Towson.
Talk about building momentum here with Miranda having such a good leadoff score. Amber, as I was about to say, has been consistently good on this event, putting up 9.8s. You know, that's important to talk about. It's kind of that freshman mentality that you're not used to the pressure. You know, whether that's good pressure, as in the person in front of me just scored well, I want to do well to continue to build that, or the person in front of me made a mistake and I also want to do well. So I think that's showing an example of, you know, sometimes those nerves get to you, whether it's good or bad, you got to be able to control those emotions.
So Lowe finishing up second routine on bars for West Virginia. We'll see Hong now on beam for Towson. Maravinsky will be next on four for Western Michigan.
Really nice jumps on beam for Clara.
And it will be once again for the second event in a row, a score right off the bat. The Western Michigan would love to wipe off the face of the scoreboard with five good routines to follow.
A nice finish on balance beam for Towson. Beautiful, beautiful routine.
Simons with the 9.575 on vault. So as you said, Kaylin, the landing costing her some points there.
Nice double pike there.
Sarah Moravansky. Garvey vaulting for Pitts.
Nice vault for Reyna. Reyna, actually, we talked about how much, you know, diversity they have with different countries of athletes coming in. Reyna is the sole Pittsburgh native, so really fun to get her perspective on being with Pitt Gymnastics. Sometimes it means a little more when it's your hometown team, so she's been working back through some injuries. Excited to see her back in the vault lineup.
Hong with a 9.8 on beam for Towson. Gruber with a 9 even on 4 for Western Michigan. So a little bit of pressure on these last five routines, though Moravansky has picked up the pace so far.
Nice solid finish there. It's going to be really, really important for Western Michigan to stay in the moment on these routines, not get ahead of themselves.
Jalen McDonald waiting her turn on bars for West Virginia. And it will be Giroux on beam for Towson after two solid scores to start off the rotation, 9.75 and 9.8 for the Tigers.
You know, each of these mistakes have made, or excuse me, each of these teams, minus Pitt really, other than I guess some directional vaults, each of these teams are leaving it open for grabs. So really important, like I said, to stay in the moment, maximize each individual routine. Nice triple series on beam.
Sarah Giroux coming up with 9.85 two days ago at Penn State. That was her season best and career best.
Jaden with a nice pirouette after a beautiful Maloney into a pack salto. This is where she really has to stay present. Good quality giants. Needs to get off the bar there. Just quite missed it. Again, another one of the freshmen that have really had to step up.
Yeah, I was looking at it before this meet. Two of Western's top four scorers are freshmen this year, which hasn't happened in a very long time, if ever, at this program.
It's hard. You know, you don't want to put too much pressure on a freshman. It's hard to transition into college gymnastics, but like we've mentioned, with the injuries and just kind of the roles that have had to be replaced this year with a good, strong senior class that unfortunately graduated last year. You kind of have to step into that a little bit quicker. It's just tough. Very, very nice vault for Pitt. 10-0 vault, front handspring pike, front half. She sees the landing, she nailed it. Chest is a little bit down, but great, great vault after a couple vaults that are a little bit off to the side.
Shruti Anand, who's had an interesting journey, started her career in Division III, then went to NC State, and now has come here and been a vault specialist for the Panthers.
Nice double tuck opening pass.
Danny Petruzic on floor.
Nice combo pass there.
Jalen McDonald, a 9-1 on bars for West Virginia. So now three routines to go, wanting to get that out of the system if you're West Virginia. And Anna Lee has appeared on the board. She will make her season debut on bars for West Virginia after missing all of this year with injury.
Super excited to see Anna. She's actually been warming up the past couple of weeks. Unfortunately, last year at Big 12 Championships here in the Coliseum, she tore her ACL, so on her bar dismount. So this is a really important routine for her, not only just for this West Virginia team and where they're at right now, but just for her confidence, how hard it is to work back from an injury, and especially to compete in an event that you got hurt on. Jason's been kind of letting her lead her way back just mentally, and well, she looks like she's ready to go now. I'm really excited to see her. Not only with her back in the lineup is it going to boost her confidence, but that's somebody that they relied on heavily last year in three events. So getting her back on bars, she's been warming up beam as well. Not pushing her too hard, but getting her back actually adds confidence and adds depth to this West Virginia team and adds quality routines as well.
Yeah, 293.275 points for West Virginia last year. She's got 483 for her career. So we talked throughout about the freshmen having to step up. This is why, because they had to fill a really big spot in this lineup.
Starting off really well with a nice cast handstand, line change. Into her Jaeger there. Again, hits another handstand into a pack salto. This is where I really, really want her to slow her brain down, be present. And a nice double layout.
How could you not love that? Absolutely.
And I can hear everyone behind me roaring. There's just something so, so, so special about your first time out after an injury, the same exact routine in the Coliseum. You know, there's tears over there.
And in the smaller picture, to do that after a 9-1 in front of you in your first competitive routine of the year, wow.
And that just shows the competitor that she is. Super excited for Anna. That's going to build her confidence, and wow, what a special moment for her and this West Virginia team.
And also, really happy to see her get back in time, because she's going back to Minnesota in 2 weeks, her home, for a meet. So really happy that she's back competing.
Absolutely.
For that as well.
It'll be really fun.
Fall there on vault there from Pitt. That was Ward.
Unfortunate fall for her. She's normally really, really strong in that event. I think she was a little bit high onto the table, didn't quite get the block she needed to complete the flip.
This is St. Clair on four for Western Michigan.
Beautiful 1.5 front layout. Really clean, executed nicely.
Jenna Wheats, by the way, had a 9-8 on beam in that previous routine for Towson. This is Valancourt's second event she's competed in today.
Really difficult standing front tuck to jump. Nice handspring layout. Switch leap on beam there. Nice finish for Western Michigan on the floor. E-pass to end the routine. Really difficult. And a beautiful ending to that beam routine as well.
Cassie St. Clair finishing up on 409.99 in their last meet, so she's building really towards MAC championships and NCAAs if they can make it in. And again, scores like that help you get there.
And this is where quad meets get really, really exciting. This is what you're going to see in the postseason. You know, you're seeing routines just nailed after routines nailed side by side. It's really, really exciting for the fans. It's exciting for the teams. And, you know, I'm excited to be here. This is fun.
Always fun.
Always fun.
Journey Lane up next for West Virginia. She'll be their fifth bars competitor.
Journey's another freshman that has fought back from an elbow injury. And, you know, she has a really good scoring potential on this event. She's another one that just has to stay present, trust herself.
Anna Lee just put up a 9-9, Kaylin.
Love it. Let's see how Journey can finish up this routine. Double layout as well. And another stuck dismount.
And I'll come back to what we were saying earlier. That's a career best for Anna Lee and her return to the lineup. Phenomenal.
Unbelievable. I think, like, you just saw Journey nail a routine. Again, it shows the potential that West Virginia has on this event. They just haven't quite put it together. So just still working through that, working through, you know, Anna coming back. You're working through injuries. Freshmen kind of just figuring it out. And, you know, I think once they get there, they're going to be there and they're going to be a good team. But this year is kind of just a building year for that. And they just have to take it one step at a time and focus on finishing this year strong.
Pitt finishing strong, one vault. We mentioned Anand's excellent vault, a 9.825 for her, and I believe I saw a 9.875 for Bedminster. It will be a 9.8 officially. So again, you look at that head-to-head battle. West Virginia's three best vaults either beat or tied Pitt's best vault.
Another two side-by-side routines going really, really well.
Murphy on four for Western Michigan. And this is Portillo on beam for Towson.
Fortunately, got a little ahead of herself on there. Didn't quite see her foot come down on that backhand spin layout step out. So she will count a fall there.
Journey Lane with a career high on bars 9.775 for the freshman. So West Virginia with three career bests on bars so far. Dismount on beam.
Nice finish routine there. Last pass here for Western, a nice double pike. Ends with her W in the air. So much fun pride over there when you're just kind of building off of each other. It's, floor is always a lot of fun, but Western's doing a good job after the mistake they made in the first routine.
Well, again, these are the gymnasts you want competing in this situation. You want a Murphy out there putting up big scores. And then behind her, you're going to have another gymnast who's very good on this event as well in Allie Shop, coming off a 9-9 in their last meet.
This is going to be a key routine for Abby here. I mentioned earlier that she had a mistake on this event at Penn State. You know, following some mistakes here, it takes a little bit of pressure off. However, for her in particular, she just got to let loose and just redeem herself here. Really difficult. Yezova. Again, I keep saying this. She needs to stay present in this moment here. Get this last handstand into a nice pike front half. And nails it.
Abby always competes with such joy, but you can see a little bit of extra relief and happiness from her after that dismount. Oh, let's take another look at it.
No doubt. Abby's one of those ones that she competes at a high level all the time. She lives at a high level, to be honest. And for her to come out after a mistake that she made at Penn State, she's not afraid to put herself back out there and try again. We mentioned that, you know, with seniority in her 5 years of experience, you know, that's the type of athlete you want. That's the type of athlete she is. So she's a good example for these underclassmen that it doesn't matter if you make a mistake. You go out and you just redeem yourself and you have fun doing it.
It's an exhibition right now on beam for Towson. Portillo closed things out with a 9.075. Peyton Murphy with a 9.9 on floor for Western Michigan. And again, as I mentioned, this will be Shop to close out the second rotation for everybody, but for Western Michigan in particular.
Western Michigan is historically good at this event. Got to talk to Coach Penny about their success on floor in particular. She said they're just rising to the challenge of, I like to say, this new wave of NCAA gymnastics. Gymnastics is more difficult. Everyone's competing at a higher level. Everyone's scoring higher. You're seeing more teams with a 196, 197 NQS. It's pretty impressive to see the growth of how NCAA gymnastics is, but they've really been a strong floor team. They have a lot of depth. They're really hardworking, and they're just up to the challenge.
Coming off a 49-5 last week, which was a season best at Illinois State.
Again, ending with a beautiful clean pass, front double full. Really nice quality. I like to see in those jump series that back leg lifted a little bit higher into that 180 split, but overall, good finish for Western Michigan over there after a mistake.
So they will get to drop that low score. West Virginia doing the same with the 9-1 on bars. And then Bean Portillo didn't have a lot of pressure on her, had the 9-0-7-5. That will be the final score. That would be the one they dropped. If you take another look at Shop's pass.
Like I said, nice front double full. Does take a little bit of kind of that wiggle in her foot. At this point in the season, you don't want to show any movement. I mentioned that earlier. You don't want to give the judges any type of discussion. It needs to be black and white. They need to be able to, you know, see that you didn't make any mistakes.
Halfway through, this is going to be such a tight race as we wait for an exhibition here on floor. It feels like every routine is going to be huge. And we talked with Western Michigan, with Penny Jernigan, a couple weeks ago, came down to that, where the final routine, it was tied. The final routine had to beat the low score. They did that. They won that meet. And that was a huge victory to move them towards that MAC regular season championship.
Yeah, it's really important. You cannot give up. Every 10th matters. It doesn't matter what happened in front of you. Every 10th matters. And even these exhibition routines, every 10th matters. So
as we watch this exhibition, we'll give you the leaders at the halfway point. Kiana Lewis leading things on vault for West Virginia with a 9.875 on bars so far. The leader is Minervini with a 9.95. Miranda Smith with a 9.875 behind her. And they've actually changed the score for Lee to a 9.75. Still an excellent debut for her. Beam leader, Valancourt with a 9.9 for Towson. And on the 4.99 that we just saw from Peyton Murphy for Western Michigan. Exhibition routine here. If you're one of the teams that's not in this exhibition, what kind of is this moment like where you're regrouping a little bit and getting ready for the next rotation?
You just have to stay focused. You know, every team's a little bit different. Some teams like to do some dances, or they like to, there's a pit gymnast with her earphones on right now, just staying focused. And whatever that means for you, whatever that means for your team, that's what you got to do. So you never know what's going to happen. You have to be fluid in the moment. And it's a part of sports. You got to wait around a little bit. So it's just kind of how it goes. Last pass here. Didn't quite have enough juice.
But still, good to get an exhibition in and kind of get it out of your system.
Exactly. That's what I was going to say. You know, it's nice because it adds, or there's a less pressure as an exhibitioner, but, you know, you get to go out there and experience. It's not like practice. You're here in front of a crowd. You're here in, you know, your sparkly leotard. Everything's there to simulate a real meet if you're in the actual lineup. So always good to get that experience.
We are halfway home already here at the Coliseum, West Virginia. Back after this here on Balance Beam. Two rotations down, two to go, and a tight race. Towson in the lead on the road with a 97.875. Western Michigan has moved up to second. Pitt sitting in third. West Virginia trying to bounce back after a bit of struggles in the last rotation. After the first rotation, Jordan Ewing and Peyton Murphy really stood out to me, Kaylin.
Absolutely. I think definitely in that last rotation, each of the teams that made mistakes at the beginning came back really strong. I thought Towson had the most impressive rotation of all the teams, and you can see that in the results there. But ultimately, they got to just stay focused, be present, and regain their confidence on this next event.
And let's take a look at that good rotation from Towson on beam. Really, down the line, they were very good.
Super confident on that event. You can see the quality of gymnastics there. Look at that dismount. There's nothing you can really take on that. That's going to be the important execution I was talking about.
Bars, West Virginia, really the highlight, Abby Pearson, you see here. But the return of Anna Lee was such an emotional moment.
Oh, super fun, but also for Abby to redeem herself there and just to recover from the mistakes that were made throughout the lineup.
And then floor, we saw Towson put up some excellent numbers as well.
Just good quality floor. We talked about how strong they were on that event and just how much they rely on her for her leadership, and just a really fun rotation for them.
And then Pitt on vaults.
Again, their 10-0 vault right there with the front pike front half. Really well done, and just a good, you know, exclamation point for them on that event.
50th anniversary of WVU Gymnastics. We're wonderfully joined by an All-American, Kristen McCree, along with Kaylin Millick. Thank you so much for being here. What is it like for you to be back here?
Oh, my gosh, it's amazing. I love coming back, watching the meets. I'm ready to get my Leo on, strap on my grips. Might break a hip, pull a hammy, both, but it's exciting.
What was, you know, you're here in the Coliseum. What was your favorite part of us being involved with West Virginia Gymnastics?
Oh, my gosh. You know, just being able to compete here in the Coliseum, so iconic. And the glory of the meets and the competition and the thrill, that's all so fun. But really, it's the memories made with the team, the camaraderie, those intimate moments before and after the meets, the bus rides, getting ready, and listening to the hype music. All of that really sticks with me and is what I miss when I watch the girls out here on the floor, seeing that sportsmanship and just the bond between the team. It's really special.
I know from my perspective, it's really, really hard to simulate that in life nowadays. So just to be able to be a part of that is really special. And
100%.
Yeah.
You had a 10. What was that like?
It was unreal. And, you know, actually, I didn't have the luxury of winning and earning that 10 here on the Coliseum floor, but it was an away meet, which is actually really rare to be able to earn that 10 being away on the road. So that made it extra special and just surreal. I mean, I was able to have that plaque and look at that and look back and have that memory for the rest of my life.
Kristen McCree, the All-American, joining us here. Michael Minnickel and Seth Kaylin Millick. We obviously wish Linda was here. What are your memories of being on her team?
Oh, my gosh. Being here to celebrate the 50th anniversary without Linda is really bittersweet. You know, but I feel her spirit is with us here in the Coliseum, always in the Coliseum. She's a legend in her own right, right? In my opinion, she made this program. And just her infectious smile, her presence, it really didn't take much in words, really, just to have her and the looks that she gave to know that she meant business. But really just her experience and the invaluable information and education she gave to each and every single one of us is really a rare gem. And, you know, she's forever in our hearts.
Absolutely. And talk about legends. We're sitting here with one. You know, when I was competing here and practicing in Cary Gym, your picture's up on the wall. What do you hope those girls are looking to you as well. What do you hope that they get out of their experience through their time here at West Virginia?
Yeah, so, you know, it's really a privilege to have had the opportunity to compete for this school and for this program, world-class academics and athletics, and, you know, something that very few people get to experience in their life. And the glory of the titles fade over time. Records, they get broken. You know, records are made to be broken. But it's really the unique experiences that we could all share that last a lifetime. So I want them to cherish it and really don't take it for granted, because it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. And I hope that they just really savor every single moment being here.
Absolutely. Really, really well said.
Yep. One of the best ever doing here at West Virginia. Kristen McCree, thank you so much for joining us here on 50th anniversary meet.
It was great being here. Thank you so much.
Thanks. Happy to have Kristen here with us. And this other rotation, K1's going to be interesting to see what these teams can do. It's been a lot of movement already in those standings, the two rotations.
It's a key rotation for all these teams. You know, Towson really, really set the tone on the last rotation. They got to carry that energy to floor, but also the gate's still open for everybody. So I want to see good gymnastics here.
Warm-ups being finishing up right now. We saw the first vault there from Milton for Western Michigan. Just so cool to talk to Kristen, Kaylin. That's so much fun.
Oh, that was so fun. She had such a good, just a good interview, good perspective, and I completely agree. This is just something that's you can't ever recreate in your lifetime, so I always want to see these athletes just enjoy it, be in the moment, be present in it, and just, it's the best time ever.
Faith Lero up first on bars for Pitts.
Pitt has really been consistent on this event starting out this year. So really excited to watch their lineup and how they're going to continue to build off their vault rotation. We have Miranda Smith starting off again for the Mountaineers on this event. Difficult series here. Standing layout. Just nailed that.
So much confidence for her, I imagine, coming up that 9.875, the career best on bars.
You know, I think Miranda's really starting to find her role on this team. She's just leads by example. Jason said that everyone just looks to her for her work ethic. She doesn't make excuses, and she's calm under pressure. That's why she's in this leadoff position on both bars and balance beam. You can see her up there. She's not phased. She's just in her zone, and, you know, that's somebody you want to lead off your events.
Career best this year on beam of 9.8, much like bars. And again, much like bars, I think that's going to be threatened by that routine.
A nice round off, 1.5 that she sticks there. Again, I think with her confidence building, the quality of her gymnastics is also building. You saw that on bars. That was a great beam routine for Miranda.
Valancourt starting things off 1-4 for Towson.
Really nice opening pass, 1.5 front layout. Just another person you want in that first spot. Someone that Towson really, really relies on. And, you know, she has a season high this year of a 9.9 in that leadoff spot. So really impressive.
And a 9.825 or better in every single routine this year, as we see the second vault from Abby Singh in Western Michigan.
Very nice Yuchenko half there. Really difficult to stick, but I think it was very clean vault.
.9775, the first score for Western Michigan on one vault.
Looks like a 9.7 to start Pitt off on bars as well.
For Lero, Simons is on deck for the Panthers.
Really nice jump series. Again, we keep talking about the quality of gymnastics here today. The execution's got to be there. Good lead off for Towson over there.
Up one beam from West Virginia goes Abby Pearson.
Abby has such high scoring potential in this event, posting 9.9s in her career.
9.875 her season best, 9.925 as you said, her career best.
Another difficult series, standing front tuck, we talked about that earlier, really hard into a back handspring, a lot of bonus combination. She missed that connection at Penn State and didn't do her backup routine. I think she thought she had the connection, but there was no question asked. So very good job with Abby.
9.425 at Penn State 2 days ago. Simons on bars for Pitt and she falls. Hate to see that.
Huge release move. Just didn't quite get the timing through the handstand of that release. And unfortunately, it just wasn't over top of the bar.
Stick for Pearson, off beam for West Virginia, and a big celebration again from her.
Again, another routine where she kind of had to step up and redeem herself, but she's not phased. You know, she's experienced in this. I talked to her earlier. She said, I'm just going to go do gymnastics today. So unfazed by the meet she had on Friday, and she's nailing it today. Really proud of her.
Another look at the dismount from Abby Pearson.
A handspring to a tuck 1.5. Does take that tiny scoop backwards. Kind of tried to play it off, but nice and controlled. And good hugs for teammates and Z right there.
Something Jason Butts has talked about throughout the year is just the team chemistry, even when they're not competing, to be together, to cheer together, to root for their gymnasts and teammates together.
I was really excited to talk to Jason about that. He actually said energy and attitude comes from the bench sometimes. You know, it's hard to put pressure on the athletes competing to be loud and cheering. And, you know, they are the energy, is the ones that are not competing at the time. So.
Gorgeous vault from Murphy.
Huge vault. Nice Yuchenko full. Stuck landing, good quality in the air.
Simons finishing up as well on bars for the Pitt Panthers. Instructions there for West Virginia's third gymnast on beam. It will be Julia Brown. She competed in every meet and coming off a season and career best for the freshman, 9.85. And we're talking earlier about local gymnasts competing. Moon Township native coming down 79 from Pennsylvania to compete for the Mountaineers.
That's fun for a Pitt-West Virginia rivalry. You know, whether you're from Pittsburgh or from here, it's always really fun, just in any sport. And it's something that, you know, us Mountaineers really, really look forward to every year. Gearing up for a series, triple series here. Handspring layout. A little bit of a wobble there. That will be a deduction. She's just got to regroup, not give anything else away. Good opening pass there on floor for Towson.
Jenna Weeks.
Ooh, really cool jump series there. It was a ring full. A lot of bonus in that combination. And Julia does end the routine with a stuck dismount.
Been a point of emphasis for Jason Butts-Roy since they started talking to him 5-6 years ago, the lane needs. And I think West Virginia has really gotten better at that as the year has gone on.
Definitely improving on that, but Julia's one that can stick that dismount every single time. So really figuring out what works for each athlete, what cues they need to say before they do dismount. Sometimes you get so amped up that you want to just get off the equipment and finish the routine because you're so excited. So really staying present and being able to focus on that last detail is really, really important.
Wheats finishing up on four for Towson. Kennedy Duke on bars for Pitts. Vault on the way from St. Clair for Western Michigan and unable to stick the landing.
That's a really, really difficult vault. A soup, 1.5 in a tuck position. You normally see athletes do that Yurchenko style vault where they do the round off back handspring onto the table. It's easier to get up more power in that way, I think, in my opinion. So to be able to do a souk vault is really difficult. That's a 10-0 vault. Unfortunately, she just didn't quite get the rotation around.
That's the first time she's fallen on that vault all year, which tells you how good she is that she's been able to land it every time.
Regrouping here for Pitt on bars. Miss Maloney too. Pack Salto. Emma Weary going for West Virginia on beam. Mindful double tuck.
Big smile from Duke after that dismount.
Nice series for Emma on beam there. We mentioned how she's been building her confidence throughout the year and just figuring out training plans that work for her. Really proud of Emma a couple weekends ago following a fall. You know, after she's been out with injury, she was able to regroup after that fall, be in her own gymnastics. And I'll tell you what, once Emma really, really gets her confidence and gets it figured out, she's going to be hard to beat. She is stunning. You can see in her jumps, just in the presence she has on this event. Her style is just something that judges really love to see. And if West Virginia can get her to the point where she just knows she's going to nail it every time, no questions asked, even on all four events, she has 9-9 scoring potential.
Dismount there. And that was the point I was going to make, is just when they were getting into the point where she was all around me, she got hurt and then had to kind of reset a little bit.
And it's unfortunate. And Emma's been building that this year from her into her sophomore year. So, you know, she's getting there slowly but surely. Like I said, it's important for every one of these athletes to figure out what works for them in college. And she's getting there. She's going to continue to grow. And, gosh, like I said, watch out.
Towson has been dynamite on four all year today. No exception. 2 9-8-5s already on the board. And, oh, by the way, they get to bring Minor Vinnie in net and is their third gymnast.
What an absolute star for this team. Really fun to get to watch her in person today. She's also just been one that has built her confidence over her time here. And
she's only a sophomore, too. She's already become a leader for this team as a sophomore.
Under-rotated on that double pike, but much like I was talking about with Emma, if she can just find the training plans that work for her, obviously what's working on bars is working very, very well for her. She's added floor. She's starting to push for beam, but she's got really, really good potential to be good in NCAA gymnastics.
Another look at that pass.
Nice front layout to Rudy. Like I said, last pass was under-rotated, so they're going to take off for that, but want to continue to see Towson, you know, crush it through this event.
Peyton Murphy had a 9.875 in front of her, so 3 9.85s are better for Towson. Noah Calafati on deck, another great producer for this Towson team on four. Deep breath on bars before Ewing takes flight for Pitt.
You can see her kind of take that last deep breath like you mentioned. Beautiful cast of handstand there. tight blinds into a pike Jaeger. Really solid handstand work here.
9.85 the last two meets on bars.
You can see why. We keep talking about the quality of gymnastics here. She has nailed every single handstand all the way through to her toe point. So nice blindfold. A little bit to the side there, double tuck, but she does get that stick.
Big smiles from her teammates and from her as well. Pretty powerful high fives, too.
Big and roar on for Western Michigan as well on the vault.
Mara Vansky vaulting for Western Michigan. West Virginia getting low ready on beam. Minervini with a 9.7 on floor. Kennedy Duke had a 9.75 as the third bar score for Pitt.
And it looks like 9.85 for Pitt on that last bar routine.
Which would tie the season best for Jordan Ewing. Their best of this rotation, Todd and Bedminster, still to go for the Panthers. Calafati on floor for Towson.
Really difficult. Front handspring, front double fold to front pike, combination pass.
.9825 the score on beam for West Virginia and low. That is a career best time routine for her.
Last pass here for Towson on floor. Another difficult combination pass there. Rudy to lay out 2 foot into a jump.
Let me correct myself, they've switched the order. Journey Lane is up now. So it'll be Lane in the fifth spot, Low in the sixth spot. I thought we missed a routine. I thought it was pretty quick.
Switched it up on us. We gotta be fluid too, you know? Nice back handspring layout, step out. Journey's another one. I feel like we keep talking about this freshman class, how impressed I am with them and just how fluid they've actually been. As just underclassmen, I think that it's going to really help them throughout their careers. But Journey is really learning how to compete. You know, she did an incredible bar routine. She switched up her bar routine a little bit this year. She's added beam. She's been incredible on floor. So I think she's going to have a good career for her.
Yeah, this is the fifth meet. She'll be in three events.
Another good pit bar routine going. Blindfold, really nice on top of the bar into double tuck, huge double tuck. You can see how off the bar she came above the bar into that first flip, was able to have time to see the landing to get the stick.
Emily Todd, a good routine for the Panthers.
Emily Todd is just a freshman on this Panther team. She actually, from England herself, didn't get to Pittsburgh until this past December. So she didn't get to have the preseason that, you know, student athletes are used to having to prepare for college gymnastics. So she had to jump right in. But, you know, Casey Jo said she's really becoming comfortable with NCAA and she wants to contribute more. She's kind of what I was talking about with Journey on beam. She's feeling what it feels like to be out there doing it and just having fun with it. So.
Saw Howie Faulkner finish up the vault routine rotation for Pitt, excuse me, for Western Michigan. This is Tesler on floor for Towson.
Really quality vaults for Western Michigan over there. Coach Penny Jernigan said that they really made some technical improvements, so they've been able to focus on the details a little bit more. The vaults are bigger themselves, they're more dynamic, so able to focus on doing the sticks has been their goal. And posting a 9.9 on a 9.95 vault, I'd say they're doing it really well over there.
Career best for the junior Faulkner. .9775 the score on bars for Todd and Pitt. Bedminster will be their final gymnast of this rotation. Lots of energy for Tisler on four right now. for Towson.
Beautiful routine on floor over there.
And now we'll get to see what Owen Bean from West Virginia.
Important routine for her again after a little bit of a mistake on bars. I feel like I keep just catching her. Again, it's tough. Amber's had such a solid season, you know. You want to see them do well, but it's a lot of pressure that these athletes have had on them this year, just kind of filling in roles, so.
Her first fall of the year, had a 9.825 one beam at Penn State. Back to what we were talking about. Very tough to do this twice in 3 days, to have the physical ability and the concentration.
Absolutely, and this is the first time Amber's had to do this. It's not normal in club gymnastics to compete in the same month sometimes, let alone the same exact weekend, back-to-back days, or excuse me, you know, with just a day in between. So it's a little bit different for them and something that they just have to get used to.
Bedminster closing out the rotation on Barnes for Pitts.
Another good quality routine going for Pitt on bars. Nice double layout with a very, very controlled stick. She's excited. Coach Lexi Funk, who was a Michigan gymnast herself, bringing the energy to that event for Pitt.
So 48-7 on that rotation for the vault. Waiting to get final scores from the last couple of rotations. 9.85, the final score on floor for Towson.
We knew this meet was going to have a lot of energy from all the teams. Like I said, it was pretty wide open for anybody, especially after the first rotation. So just seeing how teams have been stepping up and just taking it routine by routine, and it'll be interesting to see the outcome for sure.
Ratasha Halsell will be the sixth gymnast on floor for Towson. One of the younger gymnasts in this lineup.
She has been a rock on this event.
Had a 9.9 on floor 2 days ago. Freshman from Louisville, Kentucky. 9.975 2 weeks ago in their home try against Temple and LIU.
And I think what's to note about Ratasha here is that, one, she's a freshman. She's coming in with, we've been talking about the freshman experience, not really sure what to expect of NCAA gymnastics, but look what she's doing. She posted a 10 by one of the judges in week 8, posting that 9.975 score. Really impressive, and her routine is not easy. She does an extremely huge piked full in to start, and she ends right here with a front through double tuck. One of the hardest routines, I would say, in NCAA, and look how well she's doing it just as a freshman.
And she also competing in a double weekend for the first time in her college career.
You can see right there, front through double tuck. A little bit loose on that landing, kind of drags that foot back in the lunge, but again, difficult routine, doing it twice in 1 weekend for the first time in her career, and she's having fun doing it too.
Big smile from her after finishing that routine. Teammates flashing the pearly whites as well after a really good rotation for Towson. It's gonna be a tight race with one to go. Towson's got the lead right now. Western Michigan, Pitt, West Virginia, inches behind each other. Another look at that pass.
Like I said, really difficult routine. You can kind of see that her hip shot back. She wasn't really controlled in the landing there, but good rotation for Towson.
Still that smile on her face too as she rotates. See the final beam score there for West Virginia. Journey Lane, 5.25. So West Virginia lost a little bit of ground these last two rotations after leading, very, very nearly leading Pitt after the first rotation. Leaders so far, as we wait for this four exhibition, Faulkner with that 9.9 for Western Michigan took the lead. The Western Michigan actually has the three best or co-three best scores, the 9.9 from Faulkner, the 9.875 from Murphy, and the 9.875 from Wervanski to tie what Kiana Lewis did for West Virginia. On bars, Minervini still leads with the 9.95 for Towson. Randa Smith in second with a 9.875. Jordan Ewing putting up a 9.85 for Pitt. She's in third through three rotations on bars. Beam Valancourt with a 9.9 to lead the way. Emma Wary leading West Virginia with a 9.825. Amanda Gruber tying her for Western Michigan with a 9.825. Leader on four right now is Peyton Murphy with the 9.9. Just behind her, Jordan Ewing of Pitt with a 9.875. Cassie St. Clair from Western Michigan with a 9.875. In the all-around race, going to be a tight one as well. Peyton Murphy leading so far. Kennedy Duke, Abby Pearson, Sarah Morabansky, Danny Petruzic also in the all-around today. So three from Western Michigan, one each from Pitt and West Virginia as we watch this exhibition.
A lot of good gymnastics I'm seeing from each of these teams. I still feel like there's some pieces missing for all of them. You know, when we're coming down to the wire for getting into postseason, not a ton of time to make those corrections. I would like to see them get there a little bit faster, but, you know, like I've been mentioning multiple times, you got to stay present in the moment, make sure you're getting your job as an individual athlete. That's going to help with the team competition as well. Nice finish for the exhibition routine for Towson.
It's got to carry over as well to your next rotation. Even though it's not a score that counts, the emotion and the excitement count carries over.
This is going to be a really, really fun last rotation, Michael. I really think these teams are really well matched, like I mentioned before. And every 10's going to count. I want to see a lot of energy. I want to see really, really good quality gymnastics.
Yes, we will see Towson on vault, Western Michigan on bars, Pitt on beam, and West Virginia on form. When we come back here in Big 12 Now on ES Plus, we'll have a special guest once again after the break. A week from today, the Mountaineer gymnastics team hosts the final home meet of the season as they welcome in the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers for a dual meet. West Virginia Gymnastics versus Rutgers, Sunday at 2 on Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus. Pete, a few rotations on this Sunday here at the Coliseum. West Virginia, Towson, Western Michigan, and Pitt competing today in a true quad. And Towson came in with the lead.
Yeah, like I said, Towson has really put together two key rotations after that first one where some of the teams had some mistakes, but I really felt like they pulled it together, and you can see it in their results.
Peyton Murphy has had the meet we expected, leading the all-around through three.
Just somebody that Western Michigan really, really relies on with her experience just throughout her career, just someone they're going to continue to rely on through postseason.
Take a look back at the third rotation. Towson keeping themselves in the hunt with some really good work on floor.
Yes, absolutely. All of these teams, like I said, the quality of gymnastics has got to be there. You can see right there, just really, really well done for them on that event. I want to continue to see that quality as they go to vault.
It's going to be a really tight race for second place. Vault a key in this third rotation, and a solid job from Western Michigan to stay in second place.
We knew how tight this meet was going to be from the beginning, Michael. Each of these teams, like I said, chasing that 36th spot to be able to qualify to NCAA regionals. Really, really important time of the year where you can't really be making the mistakes. You have to figure out what lineups are going to work, what lineups are going to hit, and what lineups are going to hit very well.
So Abby Pearson having a great next-to-last home meet, and then on bars, a solid job from Pitt to stay just 0.25 behind Western Michigan for second place.
And Pitt's a team that's going to continue to build under Casey Joe. Really excited to see them, but we'll see how this last rotation goes.
I am once again outnumbered by WVU gymnastics legends. Janae Cox-Asbury joins us now. Janae, welcome.
Thank you.
You're a WVU Hall of Famer. Let's start there. What does that mean to you to be up in the rafters of the Coliseum?
You know, it's not something you ever expect when you get in. You just want to come in and do your job. So it was exciting, and it's cool for my kids, to be honest. They love to come back and, like, see it. So it probably means more to them. You know, it's a little hard for me to, like, look up there, but it was a lot of fun, and I really enjoyed it.
Janae, you're just somebody that holds the record for total points, you know, somebody that we all looked up to my whole career, and I know these girls are looking up to. What does that mean to you to just kind of set the standard for what West Virginia gymnastics is all about?
Right. You come in, like, having goals, but that isn't ever really on your radar. And hopefully people can surpass it. You know, hopefully West Virginia continues to build and get better, and my records just go away, you know. But it's awesome. It's great that you have your hard work pay off and to be able to represent your school well.
So. You competed in the all-around 50 times. How did you physically do that for 4 years?
I was very lucky with not really being hurt ever or major injuries, and so that was helpful. And just kind of tried to be smart with how we trained and things like that as well. So,
what does it look like to be here in the Coliseum? Just look, the change in leotards, change in just the environment, and just it's been really fun to see how NCAA has progressed. But what about West Virginia? What does it mean to you to just still come back and see it progressing, you know?
Yeah, I mean, it's awesome. We always love to come back and watch Linda. So it's so sad that, like, she's not here, but it's so great to see some traditions that are still there and just continue to support them and be excited for them.
Janae, we'd love for you to stay with us for a little bit, talk about this for, especially for West Virginia. What's the meeting like right now in that huddle, you know, as a gymnast? What are you hearing from your coaches?
Yeah, you're just kind of sometimes hearing some, like, last-second details, but just mostly, like, motivating. Like, you know, let's finish this out. Let's, like, make it fun for the crowd and things like that. So, yeah.
What was your favorite part about competing in the Coliseum?
Just like the home crowd, you know what I mean? Like you knew what to expect, you knew what your equipment felt like, so like that kind of stuff wasn't ever a question coming in. And just kind of being there with all your girls the whole time, so that was great.
Sinead Cox-Asbury, our guest right now. Fourth rotation will be Towson on vault, Western Michigan on bars, Pitt on beam, West Virginia on floor, and already underway on bars is Petrusik for Western Michigan.
Like I mentioned earlier, this is going to be a key rotation for all these teams. Need to make sure the quality of gymnastics is there. Good start for Western Michigan on bars.
Janae, at this point of the season, how much of this is mental and how much of this is just muscle memory?
Yeah, it's just muscle memory. You know, like the gymnastics is there. You've done it enough to know. You know, you do need to make sure your body's not too tired and things like that. But it's just having confidence at this point to, like, execute the way that you have been training to execute.
Jenna Wheats will be the first vaulter for Towson. Deep breaths from her. Swing of the arms. Walks in on that beat, on that vault, and off she goes.
Really good start for the Towson team on vault. You can see from our angle, I'm not sure what the judges can see from theirs, a little bit of split legs onto the table, but very minimal deduction on the landing. You can see right there, a little bit split legs there, but she does take a tiny hop. Overall, good start.
West Virginia will begin with Kiana Lewis on four. She's had an excellent meet.
Kiana has been somebody that West Virginia has looked to in this leadoff spot on floor to start the floor party. Janae, what do you remember about floor parties in your time here?
My biggest memory from floor, honestly, Linda would always ask me before my meet, like before the competition or before the floor team, hey, what routine, what pass do you want me to take this meet? And I'm like, oh, you can take my second pass, or you can take my third pass. So like for us, that was kind of like always the fun thing. And then we had the musket. I don't know if you guys had like the gun shot at the start. So like that was always kind of fun. It was different for like stood out for West Virginia.
Kennedy Duke, one beam for Pitts.
And we talked about how Kennedy's been a key player just as a sophomore on this Pitt gymnastics team. You know, coming in from British Columbia, growing her confidence in her time, and she's made it into that leadoff spot. It's a really important position. Kiana having some fun here, getting ready for last pass. Janae, what's something that worked for you going into your last pass in your floor routine?
I really just concentrated a lot on my breathing, honestly, and then just kind of just trusted everything else after that. But if I felt like my legs were good, I knew I could, you know, finish it good.
I think Kiana's legs felt good there.
Yeah, yeah.
Second meet of the weekend, and you'd never know it. Coming off a 9.825, puts up another excellent score. Kiana Lewis trying to chase that 9.875. That was her season best back at the early part of the season against Penn here on the 21st of January.
I've been really excited to see how Kiana's confidence has grown this year. I know she's a senior, but sometimes there's a little added pressure as a senior. You know, you want to go out doing your best gymnastics. I felt like at the beginning she was a little bit more nervous, but now I feel like it's just, like you said, Janae, second nature to them, and she's just having fun.
Just saw a vault from Adriana Hoffman for Towson. Her first competition of the day.
Huge Takachev on bars for Western. Nice shoot over handstand. Really aggressive bar swinging here. Huge dismount. A full twisting double layout. You do not see that in the NCAA. A lot of gymnasts, you know, might be able to do those tricks. Janae, would you agree that sometimes you kind of dumb down the routine, for lack of better words, just to make sure it's good quality? But to be able to do a good quality routine with a lot of big skills in it is impressive.
Yes, it is. Sometimes people find it easier to twist that double layout, though, than, like, just staying straight on it. I was not one of those people, but some people do find that easier.
My job's easy right now. I just let you two go, and the audience gets everything they need. It's wonderful.
Now that we're looking at some leotards, the progression of leotards for both of us, you know, you before me and then now, just to see so much more sparkly. Where were these sparkles when we were doing it?
I know. I really enjoyed that, like, leotard countdown rank thing that West Virginia did at gymnastics. It was funny to, like, listen to how they, like,
interpreted
our leotards. But, you know, our alumni meets, we would do throwback leotards for warm-ups, and that was fun to kind of see what they used to look like as well.
Speaking of, you know, I asked, Brooke was one of the ones who called me in particular. Yes. Old-timey.
I heard that.
She said, if I had known it was that year, I wouldn't have thought it was old. I'm like, it's okay. It was literally 10 years ago. She was like, I feel bad. I'm like, mm-hmm. Someone's going to call you old-timey one day.
Abby Singh had a 9.8 on bars. Yes, and we made sure to say that. Like, 10 years from now, note in the phone, tell the gymnast that they could have your Leos.
This Leo will be old-timey then.
That's right.
Good routine going for Brooke. A little bit cut up in the second pass, but she recovered with an extra dance bonus. And another huge vault for Towson over there.
Hope let's say.
Last pass for Brooke. Nice double tuck. Really, really controlled landing there.
Brooke Albin going second for West Virginia. Peyton Murphy getting final instructions before she goes up on bars for Western Michigan. Same story on beam for Pitts.
Beam is an event that Casey Jo McPherson is very well qualified in coaching. She took the Missouri team to really high standards. They were 10th in the nation on balance beam when she was an assistant coach there in 2021. Their team posted 49 plus multiple times on that event. So as she gets comfortable with this Pitt gymnastics team, I would venture to say she can do the same here.
Jordan Ewing up right now for the Panthers.
Really good routine going again for Western Michigan on bars. She did a really unique release move right there.
We saw Peyton Murphy immediately clutch the shoulder there and try and work it out and go back for some chalk. So chance now to regroup on bars for Western Michigan. Meanwhile, Ewing doing a great job on beam for Pitt.
Really aggressive series. Nice back handspring layout, step out. Janae, how did you prepare for balance beam? We know how mental that event can be, and you were just so good at every event, but what was something you really focused on to go up on balance beam and do well?
I did a lot of mental sets. I couldn't watch a lot of people ahead of me. I might watch the first girl, and that was kind of it. And then I would just kind of stay in my zone and try my best to just, like, focus in on that. And that's how I felt more comfortable going up there on the last event.
Is that something where you would go to the coach and say, hey, I'd rather be a little bit later in the rotation so I can kind of mentally focus in?
No, I mean, we never really had a say where we were in lineup, but and we were able to just kind of prepare how we felt the most comfortable. Some girls could watch the whole thing and they loved it and they didn't want to think about it. I just wanted to know, like, I could control what I could control. So I didn't want to, I mean, you can hear it. You can tell if a routine's good or not good, but it just made me feel more calm. Just kind of being in my own zone.
Brooke Albin with a 9.85 for West Virginia. Dirty Lane up next.
Another really good quality Towson vault. I know they've been working a lot on just having bigger vaults and working on the little details. These vaults look really good over there. Still taking some landing deductions, but overall good quality.
That is a career best for Brooke Albin on floor, by the way.
We talk about how important that leadoff position is. Kiana going 9.875. Brooke adding to the momentum of that 9.8 range. Journey's one that could easily put up a big number. Starting to have a little bit more fun on floor, I think, as a college gymnast.
One of the many challenges of freshman year, right? It's just getting acclimated to doing what you do every day, but doing it in front of an arena, in a rotation with a team.
Yes, I famously told Linda when I came in freshman year that I would do a lot of things for her, but do not ask me to shake my rear end or do something else on the floor routine. I don't think I could do it, Linda. Or smile really cheesy, but I can, like, look at the judges, and she was like, just give it, like, you know, wait until your senior year, and maybe you'll think differently about it, so.
Did you think differently about it?
I got got better. I definitely got better. I mean, I was always decent about, like, looking at the judges, but some of the other stuff was a little bit harder.
Brandon Garvey with a fall on beam for Pitt. She'll have to recover.
What's something you would say is important as a gymnast when you do have a mistake, whether that's in a particular event or during that routine itself? How did you kind of regroup, and what would you kind of give advice on when it comes to that?
I think you have to go back to your cues. Like, most gymnasts have those mental cues, and I think you just kind of have to forget about what you just did and stay focused on the skill that's at hand and not think too far ahead or continue to think, like, backwards. So you just have to stay in that present moment.
Really important in this rotation. Again, we keep talking about how every routine here today has, or every team has had some mistakes here today. So, you know, how each of these athletes have been bouncing back. For example, this bar routine being really important. She just missed that connection. So I think it's really important what you said is just to kind of stay in the moment and don't think about what happened just in front of you. You got to get your job done.
Some more advanced ski on Lars, and she'll come off. See the emotion in her face as she takes a breath to regroup.
I think that's another important thing to talk about. You can't really let your emotions get to you. It's hard because you're such a close team. You really back each other up. So when you see, sometimes when you see one of your teammates make a mistake, you kind of feel for them. But putting those emotions aside, being really present, I feel like a broken record. I say that a lot, but it's really, really important for this sport.
Halsell with the vault for Towson. All four of their scores have been 9-7, 7-5 or better. So the Tigers are getting what they want out of this fourth rotation.
I think sometimes you try to do more than what you need because you're trying to make up for maybe a miss. And so you just go harder, or you know, you don't just do your own gymnastics, and that's kind of where you get in trouble sometimes too.
West Virginia had a pretty big gap to make up in this rotation, but the door is open for them. We've had falls and mistakes on every other rotation.
And that's what this sport is about, especially postseason. I know Janae knows you've been a part of NCAA National Championships yourself as an individual. Really, really exciting environment. It's electric. It's one of my favorite things to do, to be able to go to NCAA championships, but you're kind of feeling that here now. You never know what other teams are doing besides you. So really important to focus, even if you've had mistakes, just to do your gymnastics moving forward. So I think West Virginia is actually doing a very, very good job recovering from some of the mistakes they had on the last two events.
Journey Lane with a 9-7-7-5 for the Mount Senior Zone 4, and the green flag goes up for Amber Lowe.
Amber needs this redemption here. I really want to just see her go out and just have fun. She's really capable of doing that. She has a fun routine. Talk about one that's had a couple mistakes this meet for really the first time for her this year as a freshman is impressive. So I just want to see her let loose and have fun.
Her last six floor scores have all been 9.825 or better.
Sleep series there. Combo pass coming up. Round off 1.5. A little bit under rotated. She actually played that off really well. That's something important to note too, is the judges don't know your routine. So even if you feel like you messed up, Janae, would you say you just kind of have to go with the flow? And
yeah, you don't want to show it on your face either. Sometimes, you know, they can kind of tell there. But yeah, you just make the best of it and just try to really accentuate something else to try to kind of distract them as well.
Western Michigan is going to have to count a fall on bars. 9.025 is the score. That's their third best right now out of four. I think one of the interesting dynamics of this is going to be Towson's going to be done first. They're going to put a score on the board. Everybody's going to have to chase.
Two good side-by-side routine happening right here. You just saw Towson with the 1.5 on vault, 10-0 start value. Does take a little hop, but again, it starts at a 0.05 difference than most of the other vaults. So a little bit of leeway with the landings there, but beautiful routine on floor for Amber as well to kind of redeem herself from bars and beam.
And Elise Tissler had a 9.775 on Friday on vaults. That's the person you want anchoring, somebody that can put up a monster score like that, especially when it's a tight race, a competitive race like this, to win this meet. And again, we said it earlier, Towson's been so good on the road. Four of their five best scores coming away from home. All factors into that NQS. And, you know, it's not normal to count road scores as kind of your wild cards, but they're going to do that with the competitions that they've had the last few weeks.
Nice blind, huge Jaeger. Another hit handstand there.
We've talked a lot about West Virginia's injury problems all year. Hits had to deal with it too. Hallie Copperwheat was an all-arounder, an anchor for them. She's had to scale back a little bit as she recovers from injury. This is the only event she's doing today, Bean.
Good recovery for Western Michigan on bars. Beautiful routine, does take that step, but again, she was able to kind of put the mistakes in front of her aside and just do her routine. That's the biggest thing you have to focus on, is just doing your good gymnastics.
McKenna King with a bounce back routine for Western Michigan.
Beautiful handspring layout.
This is Julie Matso, the freshman from Norway, on beam for Pitts. Back to the floor in West Virginia.
Abby training a new floor routine here. Opens with a huge double layout. Look at the height. Nice pop to lunge.
She's taking her fifth year. Janae, would you have done that? Would you have taken the fifth year if you would have had the option?
I probably would have. I came back and helped the team my fifth year. I wasn't, yep, like, beat up, you know, physically. So I probably would have. I would have enjoyed that.
The record book would have been unassailable if I had done a fifth year.
I would have definitely done it as well.
And something Jason Butts talked to us last year about with Kendra Combs was still having that desire and that hunger to do new things, to improve. And again, the physical part of it's so big too. To physically be able to do a fifth year is the hardest part.
Especially too, these fifth years had to kind of take that gap in training for a while with the unknown of COVID, yep, and what was going to come of practice and the next meet. So, and having to end season early, that, you know, how hard is it, Janae? Gymnastics is a sport that you really have to train consistently. Like, what would you kind of say about that gap?
Yeah, that was interesting. You know, I mean, we're so ingrained mentally, I think, and physically to train all year round and to be ready. I think almost it's harder physically or mentally, I mean, because your gymnastics is there, like, you remember, but it was such a different method of training, I think, probably for those girls, that it was hard to be confident in your training when it was so different than how you've done before.
Yeah, and you can criticize the NCAA for a lot of things. This is something they got right, giving that extra year option to these gymnasts that were affected.
Yeah, I wish they would have given it to, like, the girls who were seniors.
I think so, too.
Like, that bummed me out. I know there's a lot of girls that were chasing records there, like, nationally, too. But, yeah. But, yes, I'm glad that the other girls at least got to make up for that time lost.
I know for me personally how hard it was. I'm sure you were the same, just to end your career. You know, gymnastics isn't a sport that you can kind of go play with your kids.
Right.
So to be done with it and just to walk out and be like, man, what do I do now? It's tough. So for those seniors that year to have that cut off and just the unknown, like, you know, senior meet's coming, you know, your last meet's coming, but they didn't know what's coming. So that's really difficult.
That was Brecken Quast dismounting on bars to finish up the day for Western Michigan.
Unfortunately, another fall for Pitt on beam. You know, Casey Joe said it's been hard to kind of find their groove on that event. She knows the quality of gymnastics is there, but. These are the front full dismount. She kind of said just with their attic success and, like, her being the new coach and just kind of the energy that they felt coming in, they almost put too much pressure on themselves. She said coming into this meet, she really just wanted them to have fun and enjoy the process and not put so much pressure. Sometimes when you put too much pressure on yourself, Janae, you know, that's when not your best gymnastics is coming. You know, you just kind of have to trust yourself, trust your training, like you said, and just let everything happen.
We'll talk about it some more as this meet wraps up, but Towson again with an excellent road score, 196.325 here at the Coliseum.
Really impressed with how Towson has just taken on this year. Like I said at the beginning of the broadcast, they've really fueled the fire from their 2023 Eagle Championship. That's their goal again this year. They want to just keep making the mark. You know, Krista McCree mentioned, Janae, you mentioned as well, records are meant to be broken, and Towson is breaking their own records so already. So to see their growth and just watch them come through and, you know, continue to improve, and it's just really fun to watch them.
Discussion here on the floor about the score for Abby Pearson is holding up Julia Brown a little bit. See Zakira Muhammad giving her some words of instruction, and you know, I think it's kind of fitting next week that we'll finish off the 50th year of WVU Gymnastics with an alumnus coming back to coach against the Mountaineers at Rutgers.
Yeah, super fun. Umi was another just stellar athlete for West Virginia, someone we all look up to. And just to see how she's progressed as a coach at Rutgers is fun. And, you know, she gets to come back to the Coliseum as well in a different way. But it's always such a joy.
Umi Beasley. Step off being bars again for Western Michigan. They have really struggled with this rotation. Conference has ended on floor.
Julia's another one of the freshmen that has really come into her own this year. She actually added floor a couple weeks ago. Jason said they were really pushing her to get in this lineup, kind of change some passes around, figure out what works for her. And she's posted 9.8s on this event multiple times. He said this routine's a lot of fun too.
First time we'll see it at home. 9.825 in her debut at Oklahoma, followed up with a 9.8 two days ago at Penn State.
Some fun choreography. Three-tenth combination pass there. Rudy layout step out. Really different kind of routine. We talked today about kind of just different personalities, what works for each of them. You know, some girls are able to come out and do a little bit of Barbie style. Some girls are a little bit more intense, staring down the judges like yourself. So I think that's an important part of floor and coaching floor and choreography is just whatever works for the athletes, what you got to do for them to perform their best.
Yeah, I agree with that as well.
Front handspring, front double full. Really fun to watch her in the Coliseum for the first time.
Box check for her, first home meet on floor, and a good performance as well to close things out for West Virginia.
Julia's another one that came in with an injury into her freshman year, so she actually tore her Achilles in club gymnastics. So to see her get out there, again, we kind of talked about with injuries and just having to come out and kind of come back from that, how difficult that is mentally, but...
So Towson, because of the struggles for really everybody in that fourth rotation, are going to win this meet comfortably by more than a point. They're at Journey Lane for West Virginia.
A moment for the leotard, always. We're looking at the Flying WV on this Leo Janae. What does it mean to just, you know, when you see that logo, when you hear Country Roads, like it's such a special thing, but to you, what's it feel like to come back and just have that in your family? Like you mentioned, your kids just kind of get to watch you and just see what you've done.
I mean, you don't realize coming in how important and how special it is to just people and the fans. And that was really cool to understand and see how important it was to be an athlete at West Virginia. And so, like, you just hold that pride, I think, in your heart, and you see it, it just brings back those memories, and you're just grateful for the opportunity to be able to do that.
I think that's something that's really special about West Virginia, too, are there are no major league teams in West Virginia. So this entire state lives and breathes West Virginia University and the athletic department. So I know for me, just I have, like, the chills talking about the Flying WV because it just means a little bit more. You're it. You know, you're the ones that get to represent the state and be out here competing. It's super fun.
Bryn Freeling will exhibition for West Virginia on floor.
Difficult turn here.
She's competed once this year on floor, Bryn Freeling filling in really for Abby Pearson in that meet at BYU when Pearson was ill. But she's exhibitioned a lot, really fighting to get into this lineup.
Janae, to you, how important were those exhibition spots?
I think think it was really important. It's important for those girls to have the confidence to go out there and know they can hit a routine, because you never know, like, in a meet, what's going to happen, you know? And so you want them to have the confidence. And the other side of that, too, is they're training just as hard as everyone else. And so it's nice to see them to be able to come out and perform for people and to really have their hard work pay off, too. I think it's kind of a morale booster for that individual who earns that spot. But it's also confidence of knowing, like, if we need you, you know, you can hit.
Some coaches say those spots are almost even more important than the actual top six. You know those top six probably can go up and hit, but to have the 7, 8, even 9 spot push them to be better, you know, that's something that Coach Day from Towson said is, you know, we want to put routines in, routines that can hit, but routines that can also make us better. So I think those 7, 8 spots are really, really important to kind of push those girls in the 6 spot to, hey, like, we got to get going. We got to be good. So.
Yeah, definitely. I think that those, you know, your 7, 8, 9 girls are really pushing your, like, 1, 2, 3 girls because, you know, they can't get too comfortable. They know that, you know, it's that their spot could be switched too. So I think that's what makes your program better.
Janae, thank you so much for being here. Glad to have you back at the Coliseum here for the 5th anniversary. Anytime you want to stop by, please stop by.
All right, sounds good. Thanks.
Thanks, Janae.
Janae Cox-Asbury, one of the greats, a Hall of Famer, class of 2020 here at West Virginia University. We'll come back with final results and a wrap here from the Coliseum. Stay with us here on Big 12 Now on ESPN Plus. Back inside the WVU Coliseum, it is a final here in this quad meet. Towson taking the win, Western Michigan taking 4th, Pitt finishing 3rd, Pitt finishing 2nd, West Virginia in 3rd place. Michael Minnick alongside Kalen Millick for this one. And really, Towson with a great meet, as we talked about throughout. And Pitt did a nice job as well to kind of have to count some falls, but bounce back score-wise. Kennedy Duke with a career best and all around to lead the way.
Really exciting meet. Like we talked about, we knew this was going to be a close one to see each of these teams come out into the Coliseum. You know, each of them are fighting for a spot in the NCAA Regional Championship. So there were definitely some mistakes. I thought Towson did a really good job. They were definitely the best team overall that showed. Everybody else just kind of needs to battle through those mistakes and not overthink it, but move forward and really, you got to fix them.
Let's take a look at that 4th rotation a little bit. And really, it was Towson doing their job to close out this meet with some good vaults.
Yeah, you can see right there, just good quality vaults from Towson. Did take a little bit of step there, but I thought overall they really ended the meet well, and that showed in the results.
Kiana Lewis on 4, led after West Virginia. They found a great lead off in her.
You know what? Floor lineup for the West Virginia team after coming off mistakes on bars and beams. So really liked how they rounded out the meet as well.
And then Western Michigan really had some issues on bars, but had some strong dismounts.
You know, it's unfortunate they had a really good meet going, but again, it's that time of the year where you got to be mentally tough. You got to be able to, you know, brush off little mistakes. Those are fine, but we got to be able to hit routines and the execution has to be there.
And then on beam, Pitt closing out with a solid Johnson walk-up. 2nd place with Western Michigan faltering a bit. They will take a 195-225 road score home with them, up by 79 to Pittsburgh. Welcome back to the WVU Coliseum. Michael Minnick, Kalen Millick. Let's talk about West Virginia first. This was a big day for them. To only get a 195 really kind of sets them back if they hope to make a region.
It's been a tough year for West Virginia just overall, like we've talked about multiple times. Just having injuries to deal with, it's just a tough year. But Jason really wants to see them kind of finish off strong.
For Western Michigan, the focus goes back to the MAC. They want to win that conference championship in the postseason as well as the regular season.
If they're going to do that, they're going to have to make fix the mistakes. So really need to get into the gym and just make those adjustments.
And then Pitt and Western Michigan, a chance to boost their scores, getting a road score today in this one to put it away. So for Kalen Millick, I'm Michael Minnick saying so long from the WVU Coliseum. Final scores, Towson takes this one with a score of 196.325. All broadcasts aired on the ESPN networks are streaming live and archived on the ESPN app. This has been a presentation of ESPN. Goodbye from Morgantown.